हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू रीड लेसन नंबर 2 फ्रॉम आवर ईवीएस टेक्स्ट बुक। द नेम ऑफ दिस लेसन इज कीपिंग सेफ। यू आर एक्सपेक्टेड टू रीड द लेसन अलोंग विथ मी। एक्सीडेंट्स मे ऑकर एनीवेयर एनी टाइम विदाउट गिविंग एनी वार्निंग। WARNING वार्निंग। एक्सीडेंट्स यूजुअली ऑकर ड्यू टू आवर केयरलेसनेस। CAREELESNESS केयरलेसनेस। लुक एट द फॉलोइंग पिक्चर्स केयरफुली। सो यू कैन सी हियर द पिक्चर। यस, लेट अस रीड व्हाट दीज टू चिल्ड्रन आर टॉकिंग। Raja, let us paint together. The second boy says, I can't. My finger got cut with the blade when I was sharpening my pencil. So this boy was not careful when he was sharpening his pencil and so he has a cut on his finger. Let us see what these two girls are talking to each other. Renu, let us go to play. And what does Renu say? Renu says, Rani, I slipped on the toy car. I left it on the floor and hurt myself. So, Renu had left all her toys scattered on the floor and that is why her leg slipped on it and she has got hurt herself. We should follow safety rules all the time to avoid accidents. Now, let us learn some rules we need to follow so that we can be safe. Safety while traveling in a bus. You must follow these safety rules while traveling in a bus. First, stand in a queue. Queue means a line. Q-U-E-U-E. Queue. At the bus stop while boarding. B-O-A-R-D-I-N-G. Boarding the bus. Second, do not lean. L-E-A-N. Lean means bend out or put your hand out of the window of a moving bus. Do not get in or out of a moving bus. Never disturb the bus driver. We should keep quiet while traveling in a bus. So here you can see a safety rule when we are traveling in a bus. Stand in a queue at the bus stop. Similarly, you can see here, do not lean out of the window of a moving bus. So this boy is leaning out. He is removing his head out of the window of a bus, which is not correct. Also, you can see, do not get in or out of a moving bus. So, when the bus is moving, you are not expected to get into the bus or get out of the bus. Also, you can see here, do not disturb the bus driver. So, the driver is driving the vehicle and we should never disturb the driver. It is a bad habit or a wrong thing. Now, let us read page number 12. Safety on the road. You must follow these safety rules on the road. Always walk on the footpath. Never play on the road. Do not run across the road. Always use zebra crossing or subway or foot over bridge. O-V-E-R, over, B-R-I-D-G-E, bridge, to cross the road. You should cross the road only when the pedestrian, PEDESTRIAN, pedestrian traffic light is green. When there is no traffic light, look to the right, then to the left, and again to the right. Cross the road when it is clear. Stay on the left side of the road while riding a bicycle. You can see here in these pictures, use foot over bridge to cross the road. So for crossing of the road, a over bridge is found at some places. So you have to make use of that over bridge. Also, when you are using a zebra crossing, just see whether the pedestrian traffic light is green. Only then you can cross the road on a zebra crossing. The next are the safety rules to be followed in a playground. Safety in the playground. You must follow these safety rules in the playground so that you and your friends are safe. While playing, always follow the rules of the game. Do not play rough games. R-O-U-G-H, rough games. While playing at the swings, merry-go-round or seesaw, do not push others. Wait for your turn. So in this picture, you can see the children, they are playing rough games. That is, they are hurting each other, and which is not correct. It is a wrong thing. Do not play rough games. Now, let us read page number 13. Safety at home. You must follow these safety rules at home. Never play with sharp things like blades, knives, and scissors. They can cut your skin. Use them only in the presence, P-R-E-S-E-N-C-E, presence of an adult. Do not touch electric wires, plugs, sockets, S-O-C-K-E-T-S, sockets, hot irons or heaters. They can give you electric shock. So, can you see this girl? She is making use of scissors without the assistance or help of any elder, which is a wrong thing. You can also see this girl. Do not touch electric sockets. So if you touch these electric sockets in such a way, you can get electric shocks. So also, do not touch a hot iron. The iron which is hot, which is in its process for getting hot, getting heated, you should not touch such a iron. Also, you can see this boy is trying to play with the fire, with a burning candle. This is also a wrong thing. The next safety rule is, never touch the gas stove and hot plates or peep into any utensil on stove in the kitchen. Never climb on windows and shelves. S-H-E-L-V-E-S, shelves. You may fall down and hurt yourself. Do not run down the stairs. You may fall down and hurt yourself. Never leave your toys on the floor. You may trip over them and fall down. So you can see here in the picture, do not climb on shelves. So If this is the condition, you take a stool and you climb on it. And if the stool suddenly slips off, you will fall down and get hurt. Similarly, you should not run down the stairs. The stairs, they are not a plain surface. So you may fall down if you run on such surfaces like staircases. Also, if you leave your toys on the floor, you might slip on it and get badly hurt. So you should never leave your toys on the floor. Now let us look for some other safety rules. Safety in the classroom. You must follow these safety rules in the classroom. Do not push anybody or throw things at anyone, even in fun. Now turn to the next page, 14th page. Yes, this is the 14th page. Do not jump on desks or run in the class. You may fall down and hurt yourself. Always sharpen your pencil with a sharpener. Never use a blade to sharpen your pencil. Never run on stairs. Always form a queue while walking on stairs. Do not hang or swing on windows. If the glass breaks, it may hurt you. So students, you can see here the picture. Do not push anybody even in fun. Do not jump on the desks. It may hurt you. Sharpen your pencil with a sharpener. Do not hang or swing on windows. The next point is first aid. First aid. After an accident, the first help given to an injured person is called first aid. When we get hurt, we must immediately. IWMEDIATELY. Immediately tell an adult. Our teachers in school or parents at home are always there to help us. They give us first aid. The first aid box at our home or school should have bandage, crepe bandage, antiseptic that kills germs, antiseptic lotion, band-aid, cotton, antiseptic cream, a pair of scissors and pain relieving spray. First aid for small cuts. If the wound or cut is small, we should first wash it with water. Then clean the area with a cotton having antiseptic lotion. Then tie a bandage or clean cloth over the wound. First aid for burns. When we get a burn, we must immediately put the burnt area under cold water or apply ice. Here you can see a first aid box. It contains all the things, that is a bandage, a crepe bandage, antiseptic lotion, then band-aid, then it has cotton, antiseptic cream, it has spirit, it is having a pair of scissors. So this is the picture of a first aid box. Now let us see some keywords. Safety rules. Rules that have to be followed to avoid accidents are called as safety rules. First aid. The first help given to an injured person after an accident is called as first aid. First aid box. A box that has antiseptic lotion, bandage, crepe bandage, cotton and antiseptic cream is called as first aid box.